all I need of you.
My name is Kat Wright, and the Indomitable Soul Band features Bob Wagner on the guitar, Josh Weinstein on bass, Dan Ryan on drums, Shane Hardman on keys, Dave Purcell on trumpet, Luke LaPlante on barry sax, and Jake Whitesell on tenor sax. This band got together via the radio bean, actually. There was a Thursday night residency that had been going on, a jazz residency for years. And that kind of dissolved. Some of the members were moving away, and some were just, you know, not into doing the late night radio being Thursday night. And I had just moved to Burlington, and Shane Hardiman on the keys was a friend of mine. And the band was put together by Shane to kind of fill this Thursday night at the Bean. So it had been a great jazz residency, and then there was this hole there. And so I moved to town, and I was like, kind of always wanting to do something I had never done before, like use different parts of my voice. And I had primarily performed at folk music, so I wanted to kind of do something danceable, and I loved soul music. So initially it started as a residency at the Radio Bean, where we did covers for the first year and a half, and then our own material came out of that. Our shows are really very energetic and very dynamic. It's a big, huge band, so we find that it really moves people to move a lot, so like it's very danceable. And I think with soul music in general, it's kind of a spirit lifter. It's the kind of music that you're kind of just like, get that kind of good old easy feeling, and you're just like, yeah.
Pack it up and leave this place. Oh, let's move.
I really like wearing things that make me feel good about myself. You know, I remember like for years, like in awkward teen stages, being like, oh, like I don't like the way anything makes me look. I don't know what I wear or what to, you know, what works. And I also really have a big love for all things vintage. I just love like different kind of, you know, style pieces. Like this shirt is probably from the 40s. And, you know, I love old things. I think that clothing is in a really sad state these days. Like the cuts aren't right for people. The fabric count isn't good. Like, so when you find like an amazing, you know, vintage piece, it fits really well and it's flattering and it lasts forever. So I love vintage.
Thank you.
In Rochester, New York, and when I finished undergrad, I went back to my hometown of Rochester, and my childhood best friend and I reconnected and started playing music, and we were like, we gotta get the heck out of here. Not that there's anything wrong with it, it's a great place to live, and my family's there, but we were ready for adventure, so we just kind of started touring the Northeast and ended up in Burlington, and I fell madly in love with Burlington and everyone who lives here and everything about it, and here I am. I feel like I couldn't have found a better place. I felt like I found my people. I felt like I could have picked, you know, I traveled a lot in general in the last, you know, in my early 20s and mid-20s, and I don't think I could have picked a place that was more ripe for me. Like, and I feel like the band's success is really an indication of that, you know. It's like, all of a sudden I just got here, and then I find these incredible musicians, and they're like, sure, we'll be in your band. Like, what? Like, that doesn't happen unless you're in the right place at the right time. And so I feel like I really showed up here at the right place at the right time and met all these wonderful gentlemen, and they really are gentlemen, at the right place. And then I feel like the community was ready, you know, for us to play this kind of music to them, and that we're not oversaturated up here, you know, which is really awesome, even though there's a really high volume of talent and awesome culture. But I just feel like I don't know how I did it, but I found my place and I found my people. Vermont is my people. This is my tribe. So.
Turning